Antarctica, the southernmost continent and land of snow and ice, was once a flourishing continent. Although today this region is considered inhabitable, it brings to bear an almost magically attractive force over mankind. This continent is entrenched in so many legends of secret UFO bases believed to have been inhabited or currently inhabited by extraterrestrials. Number 5. Protected UFO Crash Site. In early 2006, a press release by ufologists contained information about an alien shipwreck in Antarctica. The images, found on Google Earth, shows the broken up ship and also a large cleft in the snow as if an emergency landing had been performed. There exists a different set of images. One appears to be old, while the other appears to have been taken recently. The old image appears with the UFO in the snow without the tanks, while in the new image, the UFO and four tanks appear vividly in the icy landscape. Many people have looked at the image, and some are convinced that we are actually looking at a downed UFO with military tanks guarding it. There absolutely exist other possibilities that we can consider here. It does not have to be a crashed UFO. As we all know, in the distant past, hundreds of thousands of years ago, the climate of this now icy continent was very different. Antarctica had a tropical climate where society could have developed. It is possible that these satellite images could be evidence of an ancient civilization that inhabited this region in the distant past. According to a paranormal researcher from Central Russia, Mr. Valentin Degtyarev, the downed UFO is 204 feet wide and 40 feet tall. Due to this fact, he considers this a monster-sized alien ship. He says, in among the endless icy desert, it appears to be the most genuine UFO in its most classic shape. After he made it public, the Google Earth image was altered deliberately in order to mask the crashed UFO. Some people who knew the effect of such action managed to capture a few screenshots along with some videos showing how the spot looked before it got blurred. However, other social media users tend to disagree with him, as one user wrote that this could just be a massive indent in the snow. The main question now is if it's possible that this could be an alien ship, as some suggested. Well, not everything has a connection to aliens. Before we make assumptions, there are also so many possibilities that we can put into consideration. Number 4. Hidden Nazi UFO Base. Conspiracy theories and ufology link UFOs to Nazi Germany. The German UFO theories put into context supposedly successful attempts to develop advanced spacecraft or aircraft prior to and also during World War II. The theories further assert the post-war survival of these crafts in the secret underground bases in Antarctica. A mysterious new theory, coming from UFO hunters, suggests that a strange anomaly discovered by NASA satellite imagery in 2006 in Antarctica may hide a Nazi UFO base. They also suggest that the Navy has visited the base during secret operations. According to this theory, the Nazis built secret bases in Antarctica during World War II that were planned to be used by UFOs. It is found on the area of frozen wasteland, also known as Wilkes Island. The huge mysterious anomaly is said to be stretching for a distance of around 150 miles across, and goes to a point where it reaches a maximum of around 2,790 feet deep. Scientists have no idea or way to learn about what is under this thick icy shelf. However, it may come to light in recent years due to the fact that the images seem to show various entrances built into the mountain's side, with the shape of a saucer, and at an extremely high altitude. The question that accompanies this thought is, how could one be able to enter these entrances without something that could actually fly away in the very same shape as the hole itself? According to conspiracy theorists, the US Navy may have possibly led a mission to investigate the Antarctica anomaly, which was dubbed Operation High Jump. This was an attempt to find an entrance to whatever might be hidden beneath the icy Earth. Many possibilities may be considered before ruling out this as a UFO base. Some researchers believe the anomaly is the result of an asteroid impact 2 times the size of that wiped out the dinosaurs. Ralph von Fress, then a geological scientist professor at Ohio State University, further states that the Wilkes Land impact is much bigger than the impact that wiped out the dinosaurs, and probably would have caused catastrophic damages at the time. The environmental changes that would have resulted from this would have led to a caustic environment that was very hard to endure. So, this does make sense that a lot of life went extinct. Number 3. John Kerry's visit and UFOs in Antarctica. The former US Secretary of State, John Kerry, landed in Antarctica on November 11th. This was a trip with multi-stops that started in New Zealand and included a stop at the International Climate Change Meeting in Marrakech, Morocco, where he was to speak on dangers of global warming. It was officially claimed that Kerry went to Antarctica to observe the effects of global warming, but it is rumored that the main reason was to inspect the remains of old reptilian Nazi UFO bases and new extensions to the bases in the frozen continent since World War II. It is very strange why a then-serving US Secretary of State would prefer to land in Antarctica at the peak of the US presidential elections just to observe global warming. The visit was said to be significantly puzzling, as there would have been other prominent individuals visiting the continent recently. Buzz Aldrin, former US astronaut, was evacuated out of Antarctica on the 1st of December, almost a month after Kerry visited. Kirill, the Russian patriarch, also was reported to have visited a Russian outspot in Antarctica on the 18th of February, ostensibly to see the penguins. Buzz Aldrin claimed to have visited Antarctica to hold a record of being the oldest person to reach the South Pole. This might have held a lot of significance to him, but it was reported that Aldrin, along with his companions, wore shirts with "Get Yourself Back to Mars" logos. Was this visit an intent to discover something that would make his dream of Mars colonization a reality? Conspiracy theorists believe that Hitler and Nazis signed a secret space technology transfer treaty with a species of aliens known as the Reptilians during World War II. The Nazis, therefore, established extensive underground bases from Argentina in South America to the frozen wastelands in Antarctica. These underground bases were used by reptilian Nazi treaty partners to conduct a range of technology research and development projects from air to space technology. The US government then took over the secret program following the Nazis' defeat in the Second World War, and formalized the takeover in the 1950s by signing a treaty with gray reptilians, still according to conspiracy theorists. This could, therefore, to some extent be proof to why these prominent individuals camouflage their visits with different reasons. Or they could, in fact, be genuinely visiting Antarctica for the very reasons they provide. Number 2. Alien skulls in Antarctica. Damian Waters, a Smithsonian archaeologist, uncovered these elongated skulls in the region of La Pile, Antarctica. Being the first human remains uncovered from Antarctica, this came as a big surprise to the archaeology world, as it is thought no one ever set foot on the icy continent until the modern age. Elongated skulls were also thought to have been a deformation done upon children of the elite class in many ancient cultures. This is done by wrapping a cloth covering the infant's head when the skull is not grown into a solid state yet. This characteristic was used to draw out the differences in traits from the higher social classes of society and the lower. Alien or not, this discovery is still plain incredible. Elongated skulls have been discovered in Egypt and Peru. This proves ancient civilizations made contacts long before history books want to acknowledge. It shows there existed contact thousands of years between civilizations in South America, Antarctica, and Africa. These skulls are much longer than normal human skull should be. In addition, cranial deformation changes the shape of a skull, but it cannot increase the volume of the skull as seen in Antarctic skulls. These skulls also have quite a few other physical traits that greatly set them apart from normal human skulls, just from observation. Regardless of what these skulls might be, human or otherwise, it is still important, for they somehow unveiled the history of human civilization. They make a very incredible, mysterious group of beings. Number 1. 14-mile-long structure buried in Antarctica. This appears to be a white blur deep in the icy barren continent spotted on Google Earth. It has provoked speculation it could be a secret research station hidden by the government or a UFO buried in the ice. This structure appears to be so big, and from its bright color, one cannot miss it even from outer space. The image continues to baffle its viewers as to what the structure could actually be. Antarctica has been embedded for millions of years under layers of ice that are more than a mile thick. The region, therefore, provides a suitable base for secret government projects or alien experimentations if ever there are civilized terrestrial beings within the universe capable of space traveling. Antarctica, being in an isolated region, may also be the reason why every single anomaly brings mixed reactions in the mind of individuals.